Oh, hello. I'm Zane, as you probably know, and welcome to my new channel. That's right, Andy's gone to Poland. So I'll be here every week on the week to deliver the spicy memes and anime reviews that you guys all want. Remember The Sims? Today, I have a very special guest here today. Please welcome Lilly Satow from Katowice Ujo. That's good. Today, we're reviewing Neon Genesis Evangelion. More like Neon Genesis Meme Evangelion, am I right? Alright. Let's fire her up. Oh, this shit's my jam. Right from the opening shots, you can just, it's just, oh, it's like, you can just... Oh, you see, I think this is what makes Shinji one of the most interesting anime protagonists. He has this overt vulnerability and insecurity that I find incredibly human and relatable. I think people will react negatively to that because it makes them confront their own inadequacies. No. This is one of the many times that Anno stops the action in order for us to fully appreciate his immaculate eye for shot composition. Actually, I think Asuka is one of the most intriguing and complex characters in the show. This is extrapolated on more so in later episodes. But these early episodes do good to establish her intricate relationship with Shinji. Actually, I think this is when the series is at its most compelling. I mean, this abandonment of narrative conventions allows for a more comprehensive examination of the characters. This is really only because Anno had less of a budget to work with, but I think out of that limitation came a great work of art.
My name's Rei Ayanami. How's it hanging?
Oh, this is one of the rebuilds. Anno remade the series according to his original vision, and I think it's really fantastic. It reflects his newfound appreciation for life and the further embrace of the image over the narrative.
One thing I'll ask.
You know what, Lily? Is it really conducive to a positive intellectual environment to be so negative all the time?